Welcome, my dear friends. Today we are going to design a wire wound high power resistor. Okay, so that resistor value is approximately 10 ohm and 250 watt. Okay, so we'll for the design of this resistor, what we required we'll see here. Okay, so let's start. So high power wire wound resistor design. Okay, for this design we require, and the requirement is 10 ohm 250 watt. So we are designing 10 ohm 250 watt high power wire wound resistor. This resistor is a inductive resistor, means small little bit inductance is there. Okay, that is approximately 150 microhenry. Okay, so we'll design in next video. I will design how to design a non-inductive wire wound resistor. Okay, so in this design we require a nichrome wire 5 ampere and 1800 mm. Okay, 1800 mm, so this much length we want and this much current it can bear. Okay, and the ceramic pipe, why required ceramic pipe? On the ceramic pipe we have to wind this nichrome wire, so it become our resistor, and multimeter for the measurement, and same inductance meter for the measurement, how much inductance is formed inside this the resistor. Okay, so we'll start how to wind. Now we will go for the practical and we'll see how we can design. So for the design requirement, I have this nichrome wire. Actually this is very twisted, so this is nichrome wire, and on this bobbin we will design. I don't have this ceramic pipe, so I am using just for the sewing purpose I am using this pipe, plastic PVC pipe. Okay, on this PVC pipe I'm going to design only, and for the measurement I want one multimeter through which I can measure the resistance of this resistor, and one inductance meter. This is inductance meter. With the help of this inductance meter we will measure the inductance of the resistor. So friends, this nichrome wire we will wind it. Okay, so we'll start the winding. So for this winding I put one hole here so that I can tie this wire one side here. Now I will wind this wire. Okay, so we have to wind in such a way that so that other turns should not touch each other. Okay, so one turn, two, three. Oh shit. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so friends ये हमने winding कर लिया है. इसके ऊपर में आप देख सकते हैं इस तरह से, ये starting है from यहाँ से, और ये यहाँ से, यहाँ बीच में broken हो गया, टूट गया. So हमने we have joined here and again this started. So this is now completed. Now we will go for the testing. It's testing. So we'll place it is here with the help of multimeter. I'm keeping the multimeter in the ohm only. This is the ohm. Can short it also. So this is shorted. So now we'll check this value. So the multimeter is in ohm condition. So the value is coming approximately. So the value is 10.3. only. Okay, so this is the value of this ohm, this resistor, 10 ohm. And now we'll check for its inductance value. So I am keeping my inductance value meter here. So first I will short it here.
and I will make it 0. So you can see it is showing 0 value. Okay, we can calibrate to 0. So this is 0. Now I will make it. I connected one terminal and another terminal to this point. So this is showing 11.8, 11.19 microhenry. 11.19 or 11.2 microhenry. Okay. So this is the our resistor. We have made 10 ohm, 250 watt, and the inductance value is 11 microhenry. This is the non-inductive. Sorry, this is the inductive resistance. Okay, any wire wound resistor is the inductive resistance. If you want to remove the inductance, we have to do something. That
so, friends, in such a way that we have designed this inductor. If you want the full design calculation, okay, you please write in the comment section box. I will provide the full design calculation. In that, you can find out the length and width and what is the internal diameter you require the winding for this resistor. Okay, so in that I will give you full design description. Okay, and if you want non-inductive type resistance, please write in the comment section box. I will give the that design also. Okay, thank you.